Hello, welcome to my YouTube lesson series, The Concepts of ICT. In today's lesson, I'm going to teach you about the coding systems or the standards that we use in representing characters inside the computer. So what is a standard? Standard means it does not change over time. So a coding system simply says how the computer see a character that we give to the computer, how it decodes, how it represent it inside the computer. We know that computer is a machine that perform calculations all the time. So to perform calculations, it should have values. So this is how it gets all these values. It convert all the characters, all the things that we give to the computer to a binary value using these standards. So these coding systems simply say how a character or whatever thing is represented inside the computer. So there are four basic coding systems that we are going to discuss here. We call them BCD, ASCII, EBCDIC, and Unicode. I'll show it. So these are the four basic coding systems: BCD, ASCII, EBCDIC, and Unicode. And these letters stand for some other meaning as well. I'll show them. BCD stands for binary coded decimal, and ASCII, American standard code for information interchange. Then EBCDIC stands for extended binary coded decimal interchange code. That is what EBCDIC stands for, and Unicode, it stands on its own. So these are the basic names of these four basic coding systems: BCD or binary coded decimal, ASCII American standard code for information interchange, EBCDIC extended binary coded decimal interchange code, and at last but not the least, actually, Unicode. So now let's see each of these coding systems individually. First, let's see what BCD is, binary coded decimal. BCD, binary coded decimal, what does it mean to you? What do you understand when you hear these words, binary coded decimal? It simply says you code decimal values using binary data. That is what it does. It simply converts the decimal values to binary by representing each decimal digit using exactly 4 bits. That is what BCD does. So we know in decimal the largest digit is 9. How many bits do we need to represent the value 9? We know that in binary we represent the value 9 by 1001. That's how we represent number 9 in binary. That is simply what we did in hexadecimal to binary conversion. If you need to know about this conversion, you can go to my previous video and watch that, how we perform the conversions between number systems. So as we discussed, to represent the value 9, we need exactly 4 bits. So that is the largest digit, And as this is a standard, we are going to use 4 bits, exactly 4 bits, to represent each digit of the decimal value. That is how this coding system works. In BCD, we represent each digit using exactly 4 bits. I'll show you an example. Let's take the number 754. So in this decimal number, we are going to represent each digit using exactly 4 bits. Here 7 is represented as using 4 bits, 0, 1, 1, 1, and 5, 0, 1, 0, 1, and 4, 0, 1, 0, 0. So that is the BCD representation of this value 754. 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. BCD. We know that in hexadecimal to binary conversion, we just ignored this first bit if it was a 0. But in this BCD conversion, we can't ignore that because it is a standard. Because this is how the computer see the value 7. You can't just ignore this first bit. If you just remove that bit, the computer won't see it as the digit 7. So as it is a standard, you cannot ignore that. Okay, hope you understood the concept, hope you understood how we convert a decimal into BCD. So that is how the BCD coding system works. Now we will see how ASCII coding system works. So as we discussed, BCD is basically used to represent decimal values inside the computer. And ASCII, that is used to represent all the other characters. Simply the letters, special characters as at, hash, those characters. Even the dot, space, things like that. So in ASCII coding system, it uses exactly 7 bits to represent each character. Whatever the character you enter, it uses 7 bits to represent that inside the computer. Simply when you type a document, Word document, let's say you are typing a Word document. So when you press capital A, it sees that, or the computer sees that character as a 7-bit value. So ASCII defines how it represents each character. So it is something like this. The capital A will be represented as
1s,
This is how the ASCII coding system will represent the capital A in computer. It simply is the decimal value. If we see the decimal value, it is 65. And also, we call that the ASCII coding system is a linear representation method. So capital B will be represented using the decimal value 66. So that is how the capital B will be represented in ASCII coding system. And C will be represented using the decimal value 67. But there is a better way to remember how these letters are represented in ASCII coding system. Just forget about this first digit or first bit. What is the value represented by these 6 bits? It is the value 1 in decimal. If we forget about this value in the capital B representation, these 6 bits represent the decimal value 2. So, I think you get the concept behind this coding system. So, you are going to represent the value of the character or the letter in the alphabet using the last 6 bits of the representation. First bit always should be 1 in ASCII coding system. Just remember, in ASCII this happens. The first bit should be 1, and using the last 6 bits or the remaining 6 bits, you represent the value of that letter in the alphabet, English alphabet. So the capital Z will be represented, the first bit should be 1, and using the 6 remaining bits we have to represent the value 26. So this is how we represent the capital Z inside ASCII coding system. Okay, and as ASCII is using 7 bits to represent a character inside the computer, how many different characters can it be represented? Can it be used to represent? How many different characters? That can be obtained by getting the number of bits as a power of 2. So for example, as it is using 7 bits, the number of characters it can be used to represent is 2 to the power 7, or 128 different characters can be represented using ASCII coding system. What does that mean? For example, let's say it is using a single bit to represent a character. For a single bit, the values it can take is 0 and 1. So here the 0 can be used in representing a character, and also 1 can be used in representing another. Let's say capital A and B. So if the coding system uses only a single bit, it can be used in representing two different characters. If there are 2 bits, you can use it in representing 4 different characters like this. This 4, capital A, capital B, capital C and D. It goes on like that. So you can see that if you get the number of bits as the power of 2, that is the number of different characters you can represent using that particular coding system. And also I forgot to tell you that even for simple letters, this method can be used. For simple letters, actually the first 2 bits should be 1, and using the 5 remaining bits, you can represent the value of that letter in the alphabet. For simple A, we can represent it like this. This is how we represent simple A in ASCII. And simple B, then that is how we represent simple B in ASCII coding system. Hope you understood the concept. That is what you need to know about ASCII coding system. That it uses 7 bits to represent a character, and how it represents the letters inside the computer, and how many different characters it can be used to represent. Okay, I hope you got the concept. Now let's see what EBCDIC is. EBCDIC is very much different to ASCII coding system, because it does not follow a linear representation method as in ASCII. And also it uses 8 bits to represent a character inside the computer. So you should get that it can be used to represent 256 different characters inside the computer. So how did we obtain that? We know that when we were discussing about the ASCII coding system, we obtained the number of different characters that can be represented using a particular coding system. So here, as it is using 8 bits to represent a character, it can be used in representing 256 different characters, or 2 to the power 8 different characters. So that is what you should know about EBCDIC coding system. Now we'll move on to Unicode coding system. We call that Unicode coding system is a universal coding system because it has 16 bits to represent a character. So how many characters can be represented? Can be represented using this coding system? 2 to the power 16, that means 65,536 different characters can be represented using this Unicode coding system. You can represent whatever the character that comes to your mind. Whatever the language, whether it is English, whether it is Sinhala, whether it is Tamil, whether it is Japanese even. You can represent whatever the character using this coding system. That is why we call it a universal coding system. Simply Unicode. So it uses 16 bits to represent a character inside a computer. So that is what you need to know about these coding systems. We learned about BCD, ASCII, EBCDIC and Unicode. We know that there are standards in representing characters inside the computer, and we learned that BCD is used to represent decimal values inside the computer, and we use exactly 4 bits to represent a character inside the computer using BCD. Then we learned about ASCII coding system. We learned that it follows a linear representation method and it uses 7 bits to represent a character inside the computer, and also it can be used in representing 128 different characters that is obtained by getting the number of bits that we use to represent a character as the power of 2. And then we moved on to EBCD coding system. There we learned that it does not follow a linear method, and also it uses 8 bits to represent a character so that it can be used in representing 256 different characters. And then we learned about this universal coding system, which is called Unicode, and it uses 16 bits to represent a character, and so that we can use that in representing 65,536 different characters. So that is what you need to know about these coding systems. That is the basic knowledge that you need to have about these coding systems. Hope you understood. Hope you enjoyed this lesson. If you want to learn more about the concepts of ICT, please subscribe to my channel and don't forget to like and share this video. Thanks for watching. Let's meet on the next lesson. Thank you.